born in Wednesday, December 18th. And on the OA funds, we're up to OAB 9, if you're keeping track of those today. Anyway, our scripture is from Matthew verses 1, 18 through 24. And of late, this has become one of my favorite verses in the Bible, because I've been doing some reflection really on St. Joseph and a way like this. And this is about Matthew's account of how Jesus was conceived, and it deals with Joseph. It really doesn't deal with Mary. And we're in the year of Matthew in our gospel cycle anyway. And so, you know, if you remember the story, but it's always good to reread it. You know, Joseph finds out that his Mary, who he hasn't been with, but, you know, he's engaged to be married, he's pregnant with the Holy Spirit. And so he's going to divorce her quietly because he doesn't want to hurt her scandal, but he's doing what he thinks is right. And God comes to him in a dream, says, hold on, marry her, and do this. And a reflection for me, you know, Joseph for me is just the epitome of what it means to be male and a man. That, you know, he had his dreams, he had his goals, I'm sure he had his ideas what his family would be like. And of course, there's nothing wrong with that. But then there's a greater role for him to play, that when those plans became part of that greater role and he changed, you know, he didn't abandon Mary. He didn't complain about it. He didn't sit there and whine. He didn't go and drink himself silly. He participated with God's plan. He stepped up and was the man and did what God asked him to do. And he took care of Mary. And of course, we know he took care of Jesus, protected his family as we go on in the story. And, you know, all his goals, all his dreams, although as good as they were let go to participate in another dream and another goal. And that's, I think, we all need some reflection on, we as men, and we as all people, men and women, that it's okay to have dreams, it's okay to have goals, but we all know that sometimes those go astray, and sometimes we just, you know, we retreat into ourselves, we kind of go into a self-pity party mode. And I think what Joseph is saying, it's okay, let it go, move on, participate in plan, and there's greater good that comes out of that. So, when we have those moments when our life is just, when it doesn't go according to our plan, which is almost every day, rejoice in that, in a sense. Find the new plan, find a greater plan in that, and who knows, maybe we'll become saints someday. All right, so you all have a good day. Pray for a little bit of snow, some wind to block out this.